let's revisit the metaverse. As some of you guys know, there are some cool aspects of the metaverse, and there are some not so cool aspects of the metaverse. So what I'd like to do today is visit some worlds that I haven't already previously visited. If you guys haven't already, check out my first video on this. With no further ado, let's check out Meta Horizon Worlds. So the first world that we're gonna check out today is going to be Bobber Bay Fishing. As you guys can see, the loading screen is always nice. I truly do enjoy this every single time. So looking around, it looks pretty awesome here. We have our instructions. So we should have a rod over our shoulder. There we go. So I have my fishing rod, got it out. Okay, so let's give this a shot. We're going to give fishing in this world a shot. Whipping it back and flinging it forward. It's a little funky. I'm not really sure why it's not casting. So I'm holding the trigger right now. I'm gonna try letting go of the trigger as I cast. So as you guys can see, this is not the smoothest experience. Not the smoothest experience for sure. I don't know if the headset picked it up or not, but we actually had someone over there that's pretty excited about this. Well, it looks like it's coming right at me. Almost. I was ready for that. Yeah, I'm not gonna lie, guys. So far, I would not rate this a very good world. I would not rate this a very good experience. I haven't visited this app in a little bit, and I have to say, I'm a little disappointed. It doesn't even look like there's any new worlds. So I was looking forward to checking in with this. So I'll wait this out a little bit longer. We'll see if I am able to catch a fish. It's also just a cool vibe, I guess, to like look around, but it's not really unique in any way at all. I'm not sure how you're even supposed to reel this in. Yeah, this is not it. So, done with this world. I'll see you guys in the next world. All right. So, welcome to Haunted High. This is our next place. This is a place I have not been. And so far, looking around, it does look pretty cool. As you guys can see, we're joined by some people here, which is also pretty cool. So, looks like the name of the game here. We have to burn growths, dodge ghosts, and help your friends. Grab the device at your hip. Looks pretty cool. So far, I'm pretty impressed. Now, I have to actually go up to this and burn it. Kind of clunky. It's not very satisfying too. If this is what the whole game is and you're just dodging ghosts and doing this, I think this is a no for me. But the environment's pretty cool, I will say that. Pretty cool map too. Oh my gosh, that's so nostalgic. The school projector. That's great. That's great. So there's the monster. No, this is not it. So I'm really just like trying to avoid monsters and burn stuff. I'm just gonna burn the monster. Look, the monster didn't even notice me. There we go. Not a very good AI though, look at that. So I lost. All right, so that is Haunted High. I lost a life, I could still play if I wanted, but I'm not going to continue. I'm again gonna say this is a no for me, to each their own. I really do appreciate how it's laid out. It's definitely like a haunted vibe, but like, I don't know why they went with this idea of burning stationary like blisters in the wall. Just kind of boring in my opinion. So that was Haunted High. See you guys in the next world.
I want to take a load, Dick.
All right, so we are back here. Now we are in Titanic Simulator. As you can hear, you may not be able to hear, there's some screaming kids here, and that's one thing I can't stand about this app, is you're not able to like just mute people easily. All right, so we are on the Titanic. All right, so welcome to Titanic Simulator. Pretty cool here. We have a lot of screaming people in this lobby, which is kind of annoying. They're not able to hear me. This is very underwhelming so far. If anyone thinks this is even kind of close to what the Titanic was, this is crazy. This is not that big of a boat in comparison to the Titanic. Oh, that's hysterical. Oh my gosh, there's no, see like the Haunted High at least had a lot of details. This is like pretty weak. And this is in the top 20. Like, come on, that's crazy. There's nothing here. This is absolutely nothing. This is 2024. This is the metaverse. This is one of the best aspects of the metaverse. This is like the social hub app where people can create maps. And this is in the top 20 of the entire app, this Titanic simulator. Little disappointing. Very underwhelming. I can't even find anything to do here. This is crazy. Look at these doorways. They're so small. All right, at least we got some lifeboats. Can't even go inside. I understand it's probably very difficult to make these maps, so I'm not, you know, trying to disrespect anyone. That looks weird. That looks pretty cool. But just not great stuff here. These vents don't look very good. Just looks odd. Yeah, all right, guys. So I don't really got much else here to show you. This was another one that I would consider a no. I will see you guys in the next one. Okay, so our next map is called Citadel. This is a pretty interesting one. I'm not even too sure what it is. I just jumped right in. Looks like we have a main mission here. Is this some gear we're able to use? Also, looks like you can obtain currency and buy this stuff. Pretty cool. Promising enough so far. Is that our weapon? That looks awesome. Am I able to dual wield? Ooh, you can walk rocket jump in this. I'm impressed so far. Have not checked this one out yet, too. Impressed with the graphics. Layout is awesome. Look at that tutorial screen. This map looks like this was made by some professionals. This is like a high budget one. Super impressed with this so far. We'll see kind of how this is laid out. And it's kind of odd because even if this game is good, another one of my favorites on the World app was Rumble. But it's odd. Like, I feel like some of the best maps shouldn't be games. We have so many games on this platform, and there's an app store for that reason, you know? So that's just my opinion. Looks great so far. Very impressive. Ooh, this is really nice. Super impressed. Even though I'm doing bad, don't let that fool you. Loving how this is feeling. Kind of funky to go forward, but there we go. Kind of found a way to just hover around, which is awesome. All right, so I guess you have to go through here. That was the level. Wow. Okay, so that's cool, but not much to it. I don't really care to continue progressing in this. I am impressed by the mechanics. I feel like this could be probably a standalone game for like 10, 20 bucks. Super cool gameplay, graphics look great. Again, I almost don't understand why this is a world. I don't know what's really social about this. I guess you can play multiplayer, which is super cool, and that makes this pretty unique, but a lot of games offer that as well. So, this is probably my favorite that we've checked out today. Very impressed. If you guys are gonna play any games on here, do the Rumble or do the Citadel. So thanks for checking this one out, and then I'll see you guys in our last world of the video. All right, so the last game we have here is Samurai Tycoon. So welcome to Samurai Tycoon, last world we have here. This one looks super promising. That's why I saved it for last. Let's grab our first sword. Can I grab two swords? Nope. Oh, okay, guess I can. Nope, maybe not. I want it in my other hand, but it's all right. So maybe you level up your swords as you go. Cool. Your first sword, that makes sense. Strike to see stats. That's pretty. So good layout so far. I like the vibes. I'm gonna guess that I'm gonna have to spend my first time. Yeah, it's getting hit in bamboo. All right, I like this. Kind of harvesting some resources here. Test your might against Ormugal. Strike the sword as hard as you can. Nice. This is kind of cool. This is like addicting. This isn't my good arm though. Oh, where'd my sword go? Oh no. Throw your sword at the bell to warp jump. That's interesting. But now I don't even have a sword. Aha, I do. Let's try it with my right arm. 24. 27. 22. Oh, I set the record! I was very determined. All right, so throw your sword at the bell to warp jump. Earn increasing XP and a special sword at the bell. I know. He's trying to help me, I guess. Look, he's taunting me. See, now this is honestly one of the best aspects of the metaverse. And the most fun I've had with this is encounters like this, where people are just being goofy and it's like fun to just kind of have fun. See, this is something I can't stand about VR is throwing. So I was a baseball player. I love basketball. Throwing in VR makes no sense. Like, I don't really understand. You're supposed to like flick your wrist and time it. Like, there's no timing when you throw normally. It's just like fundamentals. So I struggle with that. Maybe I can like toss it. All right, that was better. But not a bad world. Not a bad world at all. Samurai Tycoon, super promising one. I imagine the more you just embark on adventures, you can duel, I guess. And just kind of unlock these things. It's super cool. So I would say this might be my favorite out of all the ones we checked out today. Looks like you can even get featured on their TikTok page, which is super cool. So that is all that I got for you guys today. Thank you so much for staying with me and watching this. Let me know what you guys think. I honestly don't really know how I still feel about it. I love the VR. I love that I'm able to just submerge myself in environments like this. But like, I feel like it's still not quite ready. So drop a comment below and let me know where you guys stand with the metaverse, with the Quest, with any other VR headsets, and what you also think of the future of it. I hope everyone watching this has a great rest of your day. Peace!